Last Tuesday, I released a video using the Nikon Z5 at a wedding. I mentioned that the auto AF still has issues, that if you're using all the focus points, that it's going to make a lot of incorrect decisions pretty often, especially in situations with more than one or two people or situations like this. There were a lot of comments about how I could set up to be better using object tracking. Today I'm going to a wedding with my wife Lindsay to test out those suggestions. To be totally transparent, I have been using the Canon R6 as a main wedding camera for this entire fall season. Prior to this, I had always used Nikon digital SLRs with single point autofocus, so I'd move the box around with my thumb. With the Canon R6 and also I guess the R5 autofocus system, I started shooting on all of the autofocus points enabled, as well as eye detect and face detect. At first it was kind of an experiment to just see how well it did, and it actually exceeded my expectations significantly. I expected it to perform a little bit better than my Nikon Z6 that we've been using for years. Quickly, I realized that the programming team behind the autofocus decision making at Canon is really incredible. The camera was making the correct or a near correct autofocus choice every single time, maybe with the exception of two times throughout an entire wedding day. For a brief comparison, as someone that's used both of these cameras, the eye and face detect on the Canon R6 kicks in roughly double the distance or further away when compared to the R5 or the R6. And it really does, the Canon R6 really gives me trust in an autofocus system that I always lacked. And that lack of trust is why I stuck to single autofocus points in the past. So with that said, I've basically spent the last 3 months unlearning to shoot with single point autofocus and trust the camera, which is why last week when going to a wedding with the Z5, I figured it was reasonable to go full auto with the autofocus. According to the comments on last week's video, it is not how the autofocus system on the Nikon Z5 works the best, and I wasn't really showing how good the system is. So this week I will be setting my camera up, as everyone mentioned, with the F1 button on the front set to object tracking. I'll be using it as a primary focus system throughout this video, which might be overuse of it, but I just want to show you how it works. If you want to see the full just auto regular system, check out last week's video. The main idea with this is that you use your preferred autofocus system, and so in my case, maybe I'm using full auto autofocus as a base all day, but I have object tracking handy to quickly tell the camera what object to focus on or follow if it's a very important moment. Basically, what it means is that I'm in an advanced single point autofocus mode where I tap F1 on the front of the camera, brings this box up, drag it over whatever I want to track, or I can use the back stick to move it around, then hold the AF on button to start tracking. Release the button, resets the box to where it was when you originally enabled it. You can also set once the box is up, that you can just half press on the shutter button as well to activate the AF on if you want, but that is up to you and your preferences. Personally, for me, I found that having this enabled to the back button specifically was kind of the way to go about it. So F1, then hold down AF on to start the tracking, release, grab it again, hold down the AF on to just grab whatever subject you want to track. I'm just going to let the video run, and so you can kind of see how this actually works in a real life situation out in the field. For me, I will say that not seeing the eye detect pop up or the face detect pop up maybe within the object tracking, that would really kind of put it over the top for me to really know that it's working, or if the box was smaller overall so that I could just really kind of focus it on exactly what I wanted to be in focus. In this current situation, the box is the size that it is, and there is some background included if the subject that you're tracking is a little bit further away. So again, some trust issues with that, but seeing the results, I'm pretty happy overall with it. So what do you think of this in a real life environment? Drop your comments, your thoughts in the comments below. Like this video if you found it helpful, and I'll see you again another time. Jobin.